I don't know why this essential feature was missing from ChatGPT for such a long time. Every single tool out there, Claude had something called Artifact. It could render React codes and HTML codes, etc. Every other tool, V0, Bolt, Lovable, all of these had its version of a code visualizer or a way to run the codes. And ChatGPT just did not have that. And they finally added that feature. Now we can render the code that we can visualize. We can render React codes and HTML code. So let's have a look at that feature right now. I'm actually using ChatGPT 4.0 here, and I'm going to give this prompt. Use React to code me a text diff checker app. Now this is the first tool that I built using AI, and I used Claude to do it the first time around. It's almost 5 months since I built that in Claude. Can ChatGPT do it now? Just have a look. This is actually an easy code to visualize. So yeah, we have the canvas feature. So when you ask ChatGPT to code something, it'll go into this canvas feature here. And so you can now see that ChatGPT is coding. And so let's see. Okay, so I have created the React app for the text diff checker. So let's see if it will work. And the focus here is this button here. Okay, this is new. This wasn't there earlier. Okay, so if I just click on that, it will render the page. So, okay, so this is what we have. That's good. So this is a React code and it's actually rendering it. So let's have a look. I'm just going to copy this code from here to see if it is functional at all. I'll just paste that here. Okay. And I'm going to paste the same thing here. I'm just going to make some changes there. Maybe remove some text, you know, something like that, and compare the text. Okay. So it gives text. One has, now that we've done so much, let's actually try and improve this app, and let's see if ChatGPT, I never used ChatGPT for coding, so this is new. Let's see. I'm just going to give this prompt. Highlight the differences is in red and green and in a unified difference. Okay, let's see. That is not even a perfect statement of what I'm expecting. Let's see if ChatGPT can figure that out. And actually, so it is editing. So let's see, let's stop this and go here and see if there is any difference. It's doing something. Yeah, it is doing something. Okay, so that is what was happening. So it is edited. So let's go back to the preview and see if it did something. Okay, so let's do one thing. Let's copy this text here. I'm going to paste the same text here. I will change few things. Okay, I'm just going to add few things. Okay, like so, and compare text. Okay, it's not doing a great job. So the output isn't great anyways, but we are just testing the visualization. So let me just give this prompt. Turn this into a full website with header and footer with multiple pages. Let's see what happens. Okay, can it do something? It's adding a header, which is nice. There's a footer now. Homepage. Okay. Okay, this is actually exciting to actually see this happening. Like I said, I never use ChatGPT for coding. I have always used Claude. I am now using DeepSeek. So yeah, okay, that's edited. Let's preview it. And one of the main reasons why I never tried to do that, to try to code in ChatGPT, was because of the lack of this feature, the ability to actually visualize the code. So yeah, anyway, so it has about page, home page. Okay, the home page is here. All right, so this is how it looks. Fine. So let's try something else. Okay, I'm just going to start a new chat. Let's try something more complicated. So right now it can render React and HTML codes. So, and this doesn't have a lot of complicated elements. Let's see if it can do something a little more complicated. Okay, so this is the prompt I'm going to give. Use React to build me a modern and slick looking digital clock. Let's see if it can build something and actually visualize it, because that's where, you know, sometimes it can write the code, but can it actually render it? Because there might be dependencies and libraries that it might have to install. And let's see. Let's see if it does something. Okay. So the preview button is still there. Let's see. Okay. So it's done that. That is pretty interesting. So the good thing about the canvas is that you can actually edit the code here. Right? And whatever changes that you can do, the add comments, add logs, fix bugs, you know, port to a different language. Okay, so you have all these options. But I think this was the main feature that was missing. So with the preview, I think now ChatGPT is actually usable for a lot of people who are not really coders. So I think that's a good feature they've just added. Let me know in the comment section what you think about it. So that's it for this video. If you'd like to see more videos like this, please subscribe to the channel, like, comment, and share it with your friends. I'll see you in the next one.